Live from Film Can Studios.
Episode 3. My name is David.
And I'm Narciso.
And we're about to watch
Jaws 3D.
Jaws 3D.
In 1975, he became Hollywood's biggest star. And in 1978, just when you thought it was safe to go back in the water, he resurfaced. This summer, for the first time, the terror of Jaws will not stop at the edge of the screen. The all-new Jaws 3D, rated PG.
Are those supposed to be 3D
titles? Yeah. This version that you can find now is the 3D version. Because the one I remember on HBO didn't have that 3D thing. What's the movie about?
Alright, so evidently this was the grand opening of SeaWorld back in the 80s in Orlando. So it's actually shot on location. I was telling David, there was no way in hell they would allow this shit nowadays, but... Literally, SeaWorld is nothing more than a lake and a stadium, open stadium, and they have
grass everywhere.
Yeah, and they have a giant underwater. How would you call
it? Undersea kingdom.
Yeah, undersea kingdom supposedly, where like people walk through and you can see underwater and all the animals that they have, but. It's all a load of horse shit because it's like exaggerated bullshit models that look like crap.
So it's SeaWorld and then they're opening up the park and then a shark gets in there.
It makes no fucking sense because they have a gate that leads out to the ocean and I guess what? One of Jaws' babies makes it in there?
A small Jaws.
So for half the movie,
it's like a
small Jaws is creating all kinds of havoc on SeaWorld.
You meet Dennis Quaid.
Yes.
Who is supposed to be Roy Schreider's son.
Oh, now hold it, hold it. Now hold it. No, this is crazy. This is nuts.
Smile, you son of a bitch.
And then you meet his girlfriend, a dolphin trainer.
Yes.
And then you meet Leah Thompson, who's a...
She's a
performer for the thing and
part of
and
the
she's
show.
Dating his brother who's a cowboy.
Yeah, there's a bunch of shit nobody.
And then there's
about.
Lou Gossett Jr. who heads the park, and he's kind of like entrepreneur.
Okay, first of all, stop right there. Let's get to Lou Gossett Jr. because that's like the only shining star in this movie. So let's just get to it. Lou Gossett Jr. Can you understand three words that man said the whole?
He sounds
movie?
Like James Brown in the whole movie.
Some lights down there.
Got him right here.
Can't see shit down there. Get me some medical attention here, quick!
I want you to clear the tunnel. I want you to let the people out. I want you to close the gate and seal the park. You hear me? Seal the park. I'll be down in a minute.
Listen, nephew. It's a $2.5 million turbine that's not going to go up in smoke because of some damn fish. Now shut the pumps down.
Because it costs too much to replace and they burn out, that's why.
You're talking about some damn sharks, what?
No live boy and girl. He's going to be him. Now we got drinks at the bar. Stay free. Come on. Follow me.
I don't know if he was going for like a southern accent or what, but I did not understand 80% of the shit that he said in that movie, which made it that much better.
Yeah, I know.
Because
yeah,
you're just looking
of all his things right now.
We're just looking forward to Lou Gossett popping up again, mumbling random shit, and then leaving, and then coming back. And
getting drunk with people, and then
coming
back.
Yeah, that is like the worst park director I've ever seen. The grand opening is like coming around, so they're trying to get all this shit fixed. So yeah, you know, you would think if there's a shark killing people in the park, you would delay the grand opening, but no, we're gonna open.
I run the park, I sell the tickets, and I make the decisions,
because Lou Gossett said so.
Then there's like a guy from like the National Geographic. He's like a photographer. That shows up, some Australian guy.
Him and his friend, which are...
Another Australian guy.
Yeah, they remind me, like I told you before, like the Jaeger pilots of Pacific Rim.
Yeah,
Australian guys.
Come on, you bloody bastards!
Guys that make no sense.
They're there, like, and then they capture a shark in the Spanish galleon.
Oh, yeah, okay. Listen, this underwater kingdom is in the most magical pond or whatever.
Lake. It's a man-made pond, but for some reason there's a...
There's a Spanish galleon sank on the bottom of this pond.
In Orlando.
A lake in Orlando. It makes no fucking sense. Okay, and if there's a part where the camera supposedly goes down there and you see a half-rotted corpse.
Yeah, corpse like this.
Yeah, it's just down there. I don't know, that's one of the... Was that the guy opening the gate that they found later? Or just as a random body?
No,
okay, so there's another random body that they don't even bother to give you a backstory. And the whole turning point is that, oh, the shark that they've been hunting halfway through the movie.
And then they realize the shark is not the real shark.
Yes, it's the mother of that shark, which is, like, stationed in an underground hangar. That's right.
It shows up at the restaurant that's underwater.
Where Lou Gossett is drinking.
Yeah, and then it goes through and it starts attacking people on the skis, women on, and bumper boats and shit like that.
Yeah, the close-ups are such extreme close-ups that it makes the shark look humongous. They literally, of course. But it backfires because then when it shows it attacking people on skis, the fin looks like an average-sized shark.
It attacks this underwater thing, which is kind of like a underwater tunnel aquarium thing where people are visiting, and it traps people in there, and then they're floating in water.
Yeah.
So it becomes like a rescue mission where they have to go down there and rescue the people, and then it becomes
they rescue it.
And they have to like seal the thing, blah blah blah. So the main character, Dennis Quaid and his girlfriend and everybody is hanging out there. And the shark escapes, and it tracks them down, and the finale, which everyone, if they don't know about it, they know about it now. They copied in Deep Blue Sea.
Yeah. A lot of this stuff, actually, Deep Blue Sea was influenced by.
They're hanging out in the underwater command center, and the shark's coming in at the big glass wall.
Yeah.
Which it looks like shit.
They're big money shot. But I say by big money shot, I mean like $25.
It's like a frozen, it looks like a frozen shot.
Yeah, Jaws comes right at the camera, and it's supposed to be literally him breaking the giant glass, that they have inside the control center.
With the slow motion is bad.
Obviously, the technology was very limited for that then. So what they did was the shark literally comes up to what supposedly is the glass. I'm assuming they rotoscope like...
Yeah, they broke
broken glass over it. But the shark... The Jaws shark literally just freeze frames. It just stops while all the water and everything else is flying at the camera. It's just stuck there. It's just hovering.
It just pauses.
It just totally kills the shitty effect to begin with, right?
And then they have like stop motion effects.
Oh yeah. Once the water's pouring in and everybody's like drowning, it's trying to eat the people inside.
And
they keep cutting to an outside shot of like the tunnel control center, and this model shark is just moving in and out. In and out. And you can tell it's on a cable, it's just a shitty model being pushed in and out. Oh man, it was... Oh, what can I say?
Okay, then one of the guys, the British guy, the Australian guy, he's inside his mouth.
Oh yeah, the body's still in there.
Yeah, earlier in the movie, he dies, but he's not even biting him.
No, it's kind of like they do a point of view of the guy while the shark is chomping down.
Yeah, that's cool that it's inside the shark. They've never done that before.
But they kept it going too long. The shot is...
Yeah, but the teeth are not hitting him. It's like his tongue and he's squishing.
Yeah, I mean, if they would have just tightened it up a little bit, just showed it really quick, maybe chomping down one time, you get the point, you move on.
Yeah.
You let your mind do the work.
He has the grenades. Why didn't he use it before? I don't know.
Yeah, that guy is holding it. Well, he's dead. It's just his arm is stuck out of his mouth holding a grenade. How perfect is that?
And then he bends the...
Yeah, Dennis Quaid has a shot. Pull.
Yeah.
He bends it perfectly to make the most perfect hook that fits just in the ring of the grenade inside of Jaws' mouth.
For some reason he was in there.
Just to yank out the pin and blow his head off.
The hive. It blows up.
Yes. Tell me about the magnificent 3D glory shot.
Yeah. Okay, first of all, him and the girl.
They're in the same room.
They're in scuba gear.
Yeah.
So, okay, maybe they survived the explosion and survived. Obviously, they're super deep.
Yeah.
It explodes. The teeth. I mean, it looks horrible. It looks horrible.
Yeah, they do.
Yeah, 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 it looks horrible. But then, how do they know that Ugasa Jr. and that woman and his nephew obviously was killed?
Everybody's in
the
this
JJ,
fucking... Everybody's
like,
in a room.
Like Dynamite.
Okay, first of all, they're the only ones wearing scuba gear.
Yes.
Luke Gossett Jr. is wearing a suit. The other guy, the other poor bastard, and the scientist lady, they're like, all this water in this deep chamber.
Yeah,
rushes everybody in, okay? They blow up Jaws inside the same room, first of all. I don't even know how they all would have lived if the grenade blows that close to them. At least their eardrums would have been blown to shit. They make it to the surface, and then is the grand finale. They're so happy they made it, and they like, oh, how about Lou Gossett? Well, whatever his name is in the movie. Oh, he made it. What do you mean he fucking made it?
He's like,
they never showed him again. He was
like,
in that
what
room.
About, what about Calvin? Oh yeah, he made it. He made it. You could tell they added that at the end of the movie because like,
because they're like, oh yeah, we never really showed Lou
exactly
Gossett again.
We didn't explain it, or they could have died. It doesn't matter.
And he's gone. We can't do any reshoots. So then, all they do is give a fuck about the two dolphins. It's like, hold on. You just barely made it out of the skin of your teeth. Where's Lou Gossett Jr.? And the other lady. No, no. Where's Carly the fucking dolphin?